Well, for more on the latest Brexit developments, I spoke to Yuval Weber. He's a Kennan Institute Fellow at the Daniel Morgan Graduate School. And I began by asking him where the UK stands with this latest development.
So what happened today is that the government wanted the Parliament to reject no deal, but what the Parliament did instead was offer an amendment that made no deal a permanent policy of the Parliament itself. So what that did is it took away Theresa May's ability to dangle no deal against the Europeans and the EU, I should say, in order to get a better deal from them. So what we'll have going forward is that no deal is not an option that Theresa May can point to, which limits her bargaining space with the European Union.
So we have this idea of Theresa May going back to the EU saying, this is what I've got. The EU is already clearly losing patience. So what are the worst case and best case scenarios at this point?
So the worst case scenario is that it comes in two flavors. One is that this sort of uncertainty just continues indefinitely. And what businesses will do is sort of like what people do under any sorts of stress. They just try to leave. They'll come up with their own exit options. And what we would see is basically a slowdown of economic activity in the UK while this essentially works itself out. And if this could take months or years, then you would see just a general contraction of economic activity, general recession, and that would be essentially the slow motion version. The quick motion version of it, of the worst case, is just basic pandemonium. The flights can't come in or out of the UK, medicines don't come in or out, food doesn't come in or out, and you have basically this civil disorder as a possibility.
So keep in mind that with the possibility of this civil disorder, I mean, how does politics as we know it survive after Brexit?
So what really is like probably, I would say, the biggest two sources of danger to UK politics in terms of thinking where sources of stability is that the UK as a political entity may also cease to exist because both Northern Ireland and Scotland voted to remain. But one of the big issues here is what they've been calling the backstop. How does Northern Ireland be both on the Irish island as well as part of the UK? And what would happen if Ireland and Northern Ireland, as part of the peace agreement of the Good Friday Accords between the Catholic and Protestant communities, if they don't keep basically that, that border open and there is some sort of no-deal Brexit, what would then happen is Northern Ireland would suddenly become, very suspiciously, this economic powerhouse because it would basically be this backdoor towards between the European Union and the UK, and that would essentially go against the idea of Brexit itself. Additionally, there could be a secession referendum in Scotland, you know, for independence.
Right.
There could be reunification referendum in Ireland. And then when it comes to the internal British politics, it may not be possible for the Conservative and Labour parties to survive in the forms that have for the past 100 to 200 years. Because this is not about left-right, Conservative-Labour, but what is your idea of Britain? What is the idea of the UK? And that basically could break apart these parties and lead to a totally new vision for party politics within the UK.
And now turning to politics in the EU, we know that the EU parliamentary elections are around the corner. How much impact do you think Brexit is going to have on that?
So this is why the Europeans are themselves so upset about this. This instability caused by Brexit is not just a British domestic question. It is, in fact, exporting instability and uncertainty to the rest of the EU. And everyone in the EU, just like British business in the previous segment, they just want to know, where is this going? And so the idea that a country which is committed to Brexit, which is committed to leaving the EU, then takes part in European parliamentary elections is to say people on the way out of the party are going to take the wine or the whiskey with them. And that is really what's irritating the hosts of the party, which just want these, you know, troublesome guests to leave.